We have progressed well through our baseline studies. We only have one remaining to complete. And as soon as that's done, what BLM is advising us is stay on track, keep focused, and we'll work towards completing our plan of operations, submitting that, and moving into the NEPA process.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Bill Willoughby. He's the CEO of Century Lithium. And Bill, it's great to have you back again. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thank you, Steve.
Yeah, thanks for having me on again. Yeah, good to have you along, especially when you've had news out today and you have the company releasing sort of an update on where things are at with the Angel Island project. And before we go any further, let's remind everyone a little bit about that particular project and the work that's being done there.
Right. Well, our project's in central Nevada, halfway between Reno and Las Vegas, near the town of Tonopah, and it's lithium clay. And we've been working on it since 2017, working to extract the lithium clay. And we've had a pilot plant running now for 3 years, advanced through a feasibility study, and have been able to produce battery grade lithium carbonate in our pilot plant, which demonstrates that we have an effective process. So yeah. Moving ahead.
Yeah, and Bill, that moving ahead really is being pushed also towards the U.S. government as well, who have made a number of comments about the importance of lithium and where to find it, but more importantly, the importance of a U.S. supply. So you're obviously taking a great lead from what you're hearing out of the White House.
Exactly. All the information that comes out that we hear from the administration and from politicians is positive. There's a great interest in onshoring lithium production, and we're well positioned for that. And not just well positioned by where the project's located, but also in our stage. We're one of the few advanced projects can say, hey, we've got a feasibility study behind us. We're well advanced into our permitting, and we have a good process that's proven effective at producing lithium product and also being easy on the environment.
Yeah. Speaking of permitting, I know that you recently have chatted, I'm sure you do a lot, with the Bureau of Land Management that controls all of the permitting. Tell me where that's at and sort of the conversations that you've had, Bill.
Yeah, well, we met with the new state director and staff in Reno, and that meeting went very well. And we've had good cooperation and assistance out of our local office in Tonopah and Battle Mountain. And those talks have gone well. We have progressed well through our baseline studies. We only have one remaining to complete. And as soon as that's done, what BLM is advising us is stay on track, keep focused, and we'll work towards completing our plan of operations, submitting that, and moving into the NEPA process, which is a National Environmental Policy Act. And that takes you through either an EA or an EIS, environmental assessment or environmental impact statement. And at the end of that road is your record of decision, gets you to being a federally permitted mine.
Yeah. And do you have a timeline set around that? I know that it can be sometimes tough to sort of figure timelines when you're dealing with the government, but are you sensing somewhere, is it going to be this year, next year, year after?
Well, all the way through the road that is laid out in front of us with NEPA probably takes us into next year. You know, we're not anticipating an acceleration. You know, you hear about accelerated plans out of the federal government, fast-track projects. You do have to complete all the steps to get there. And that's what we're doing. We're checking all the boxes right now. And we feel like we're in really good position for that.
Okay. And lastly, Bill, just on Angel Island one more time, you know, you talk in the news release that 34,000 tons per year of this lithium carbonate, 40-year mine life. But the key is that everything's there on site. And that's the big part of this, isn't it? That from where you want to take it to where you want to get to is all within a pretty easy spec as far as time and space is concerned.
Well, yeah, the big factor there is that it's all a contained process. We're going from the claystone, which has lithium, all the way to a battery product at the end of the road. We don't need to have evaporation ponds. We don't need to ship concentrate offshore to be treated. It's an end-to-end process. And that's the real attractive feature of looking at clay deposits, looking at some brine deposits with DLE. But for us, it's an end-to-end process. And we've proven in our pilot plan, at least, that it works quite efficiently.
Absolutely. Bill, thanks so much for the update. Really appreciate it. I know there's lots of work ahead, and we appreciate your time joining us to update us on where you're at.
Yeah, thank you, Steve. It's good to be with you again.
All right. Bill Willoughby, the CEO of Century Lithium.